Hi students, very good morning. Till the last lecture we were discussing with respect to zero order, graphs of zero order and the special order of zero order kinetics, and we have solved some problems with respect to that. And now in this lecture we are going to deal with respect to first order kinetics. Okay, so what does it say? A, it is a reactant getting converted to product. This is generally will be present, and rate of reaction I have mentioned that it is of first order, so that it will be K into rate of concentration. So when we plot the graph with respect to rate of reaction with respect to concentration, see rate of reaction with respect to concentration, so what happens, it will be a straight line passing through the origin, because the graph will be like y is equal to mx form. Now if you go for the integrated rate law, so here if you write this one, this will be in the pattern of R is equal to K into A whole power 1, because it is of first order. And from this equation we can write here R is equal to minus 1 by 1 dA by dt. This is the second equation. So these two belongs to same content. Rate is same. So these two will be equal. So minus dA by dt, this one, it is equal to K into A. If you say minus that side, it will become K into dt. On integrating both sides, so if you bring concentration of A this side and if you send K dt this side, what happens? dA by dt will be equal to minus K into dt. On integrating, what happens? Integrating of dA by A is equal to minus integrating of K dt. So dA by A, integration of dA by dt is equal to ln EA. Okay, this is ln natural log to the base E A. So ln E A and K dt, it will be equal to T. If you apply the limit from the initial concentration to the final concentration, whatever that has been left out. Here also from initial time to the time at which some concentration has been left out at this time. So it will be equal upper limit minus lower limit, this one with this one. So equal to minus K T with upper limit, T with lower limit. So it will be T minus 0. So this one in one more form it can be written as ln EA minus ln E A naught minus KT. Okay, if you subject this one, if you this one goes this side, what happens? Plus ln E A naught minus KT. And we should remember that 1 ln or 1 natural log ln to the base E is equal to 2.303 log base 10. 1 natural log base E is equal to 2.303 log base 10. So instead of ln, 1 ln, you can keep it as 2.303 log 10 minus KT plus here 2.303 log 10 base A naught. So if you plot the graph for this, what you will be getting? And you can take, you have written as 2.303 log, right? If you send 2.303 this side, what happens? Log 10 concentration A will be equal to minus K by 2.303 into T. Already here 2.303 is present. In denominator also you will be getting 2.303. Those two will be cancelled and you will be getting log A concentration. Okay. See, if I plot the graph with respect to log 10 concentration A with respect to time. So what it will be? This one is minus M, slope is negative, so that you will be getting minus K by 2.303 Mx. This one is intercept. This intercept is log 10 base, log base 10 concentration of A initial concentration. See this equation. See, this is the final equation. Above one is also final equation anyway. So we can write all first order equations in terms of like this. K is equal to 2.303 by K log initial concentration by final concentration. See, if you subject here T, then automatically you will be getting the same thing. Okay? Subject T. This one, if you send this, it becomes minus log A concentration. Log A concentration minus log A initial concentration will be equal to log initial concentration by final concentration. If you send minus also that side, then you will be getting, if you subject T here, you will be getting 2.303 by K log initial concentration of the reactants by the final concentration of the reactants. And one more way, we have done already here, this one, this is nothing but this equation or this equation, anything, this equation, the same equation you can write here, ln E minus ln E A naught equal to minus KT. So this one also, this ln natural log also will follow the same rules of as that of log. So log A minus log B, you will be getting log A by B. So log ln E by A naught equal to minus KT. And if you remove this ln, what happens? If you remove ln, it will become, this one will change entire as the power of exponential. If here it is log, this one will change to the power of 10. Okay. So, if you remove ln, it becomes e. If there is log, this e, instead of e, you will be having 10. So, you are removing ln. So, a by a naught will be equal to exponential power raised to minus kt. A is equal to a naught into minus e kt. A is equal to a naught e power minus kt. And this is the exponential form of the first order reaction. This is the way of calculating the t time. So, now what you are doing is, you are plotting a graph with respect to concentration of the reactant with respect to time. So, if you take initial concentration of A is equal to A naught at time t. So, if you put time t, what will happen? Anything, this one entire thing will become equal to 0. Right? So, anything to the power of 0, it is 1. So, A will be equal to A naught. So, this is the condition where concentration will be equal to A naught at time is equal to t. 0. At time is equal to 0, concentration A will be equal to A naught. Means initial concentration. This is the initial concentration at the starting point. Means time is equal to 0. Okay. Now at time infinity, if you place the time infinity, you will be getting the value of infinity only. So it will be going on. As the concentration of the reactant going on decreasing with the time. But it will never end up. You will be getting the infinite value. If you keep the value of infinity here, the value of A will be equal to, not defined. So it will be getting infinity value only. It will never end up. So this is the graph you will be getting with respect to concentration of reactant with respect to time in the exponential form. Okay. Now, half-life of the reaction means, already you have learned with respect to zero order, time in which the reaction completes 50%. 50% of the reactant has been completed. How much time it has been taken, that is called as T half. T is equal to 2.303 by k log initial concentration by final concentration. T half is equal to 2.303 by k log initial concentration is A naught. Final concentration, as we are mentioning, T half means half it has been completed. So it is A naught by 2. A naught will be cancelled. So that will be getting log 2. Log 2 value is 0.3010. 2.303 into 0.3010 will be getting 0.693 by k. Means T half of the first order, it is not at all depending upon the concentration of the reactant. Okay. Or we also know that 2.303 log is equal to 1 ln. So T half will be equal to ln 2. Because 2.303 log is equal to ln. Okay. So you can write in this way, 2.303 by k into log 2 or ln 2 by k. T half will be equal to 0.693 by k if you substitute the value of log 2. So, all the radioactive reactions, whatever you are seeing, they will be coming under the first order. And going for in the lifetime of reaction. Lifetime of reaction means the entire reactant has been completed. Okay. Time in which the reaction completes 100%. Okay. There will be no lifetime like that. First order reaction will not complete at all. Why? If you have any questions, you can substitute here. T lifetime will be equal to 2.303 by k log initial concentration by final concentration. Final concentration, how much will be remained if it is completed completely? Nothing reactant will be remained. So it is 0. A naught by 0. So you will be getting A naught by 0, it is infinity. So the T lifetime will never complete. So T, whenever it is lifetime, for the first order, if it is taken as infinity, the reaction will never complete 100%. Okay? And the graphs with respect to the first order. So, rate of the reaction with respect to concentration. Okay, this is the equation. R is equal to K into A power 1. So, rate is directly proportional to the concentration. You will be getting a straight line passing through the origin. And the slope is equal to tan theta is equal to K. Rate with respect to time. This one R is equal to K into A. If you go with respect to time T. Okay, this goes on decreasing with respect to time and it never ends up. Next, log A with respect to time. Concentration. Already we have done log A is equal to minus K by 2.303 into T log A naught concentration. So log with respect to time, you will be getting the negative slope. And slope value is this one, minus K by 2.303, that is equal to tan theta. For that equation, and this one with respect to ln, instead of log, you are going for ln. Same negative slope, here tan theta will be equal to K because you are not going for logs. If it is log, K by 2.303. Concentration of reactants with respect to time. This is the condition, same. A is equal to A naught e power minus kt. This is the same thing. Next, it is T half with respect to concentration. And we know that T half we have got 0.693 by k. So, it is not at all depending upon the concentration. See, for first order, A naught by 2k, T half is directly proportional to concentration of the reactant in zero order. In zero order, T half is directly proportional to the concentration of the reactant. in the first order, T half is independent of the concentration of the reactant. Next, going for the concentration of the product with respect to time. How to plot this one? Already we know that initial A is present, it is getting converted to product B. T is taken 0, means that T time is equal to 0, A will be equal to A naught. B is nothing present here. At time T, some amount of A has been converted to product. So A naught minus X, it gives rise to product X. So A will be equal to, we know that equation, A is equal to A naught into e power minus kt. And A is nothing but A naught minus X, this is what at time T. So it is equal to A naught e power minus kt, X is equal to, if you subject this as X and if you send this on this side, what happens? You will be getting minus A naught e power minus e kt. So that if you take A naught common, X will be equal to A naught into 1 minus e power minus kt. So this is the concentration. What is mean by X? This is the concentration of the B after some time t. So with respect to X, that is the concentration of the product, and time, this is the graph. If you plot the graph, you will be getting in this pattern. These are the graphs what you can expect with respect to the first order. Hey students, this is the information. Now let us take some questions with respect to first order. A first order reaction, the concentration of reactant decreases from 800 moles per decimeter cube to 50 moles per decimeter cube in 2 into 10 power 4 second. Find K, means he has mentioned time. He has mentioned in terms of moles. Moles per decimeter cube means it is nothing but concentration only, right? Okay, initial concentration is this one, final concentration is this one. So T is equal to, options are these things. If you are capable of doing, you can do directly, or if you can take one or two examples here and you can solve it. So T is equal to 2.303 by K log initial concentration by final concentration. Initial concentration, he has mentioned it as 800. Final concentration as 50. So K, instead of K, you should find out the K. If you send K this side, you will be getting T in the denominator. 2.303 by T. What is the T value? It is 2 into 10 power 4 seconds. So it is 2.303 by 2 into 10 power 4 into log 800 by 50. So 800 by 50 means you can get directly as something like 8s are, right? So you can do 2.303 by 2 into 10 power 4 into 4 into 0.3. You will be getting the value approximately 1.37 into 10 power minus 4 second inverse. So option is C is the answer. Next one, a first order reaction, 20% completed in 5 minutes. Find the time in which 60% completes. So generally this is the formula whatever we will be taking. So for 20% completion, if 20% is completed, how much will be remained? 80 will be remained. Percent means 100, right? 20 is completed. From 100, 20 is completed means 80 is remained. So I am taking the equation like 2.303 by K log initial is 100, final 20 has been completed, so 80 has been remained. Here 60%, next one, for T, this T20 has been given as 5. T60, you should find out, it is 2.303 by K log initial is 100%, final 60% is completed means 40% will be remained, so it is 100 by 40. So T20 is 5 minutes, T60 is X. You should find out that these two will be cancelled. You will be getting log 10 minus log 8 in the denominator, log 10 minus log 4. So it is 5 by X. Log 10 is nothing but 1. Log 8 is nothing but log 2 cube. Here log 4 means 1 minus 2 log square. Log 10 is 1. So 5 by X, 1 minus, you will be getting 3 log 2. Log 2 value is 0.3010, or you can take it as 0.3. So 3 into 0.3 in the denominator, 2 into 0.3. So 5 by X is equal to 0.1 by 0.4. And X will be getting it as 20 minutes. So the answer is B. Okay students, I hope that you understood this. Whenever you are having with respect to completions, you take in this pattern, you will be getting the answer. Or from this, you can calculate the value of K from this equation, because you know T. You can calculate K. You can calculate K and you can keep that place K here. There is one more pattern. This is a very simple one. You can do directly. Okay. Next. A is getting converted to product. It's a first order reaction. The concentration of A changes from 0.1 molar concentration to 0.025 molar concentration in 40 minutes. Find the rate of reaction when concentration of A is 0.01 molar. So pause the video and try to solve the students. A is equal to 2.79 into 10 power 4. B is equal to 3.47 into 10 power 4. C is equal to 2.79 into 10 power 4. D is equal to 3.47 into 10 power minus 4. Okay, this is the thing you should find out. R is equal to K into A, and A concentration, he has mentioned it as 0.01. Here he has mentioned. So you should know the value of K. to know the value of k, you can calculate by using this one. T is equal to 2.303 by k log initial concentration by final concentration. Initial concentration is 0.1. Final is 0.025. 2.303 by, what is the time he has given? He has given us 40 minutes. So if k value will be getting 3.454 into by 100. So you keep the k value here. Concentration is 0.01 he has mentioned. Further you are finding the rate of the reaction. So rate will be equal to 3.4 into 10 power minus 4. So students, take this question. If for a first order reaction k is equal to this much, he has given the value of k. Find t half, t 1 by 3, 2 by 3, t 3 fourth. Getting this? T half means half is remained, or simply you can go for 0.693 by k. You will be getting the value. This one, you solve this, students. T 1 by 3. T 1 by 3 means 1 by 3 is completed. How much is remained? 2 by 3 is remained. So you can write it as 1 minus 1 by 3 in the denominator. Log initial is 1. 2.303 by k. K value is this one. So you solve this, you will be getting the answer. T 2 by 3. 2 by 3 is completed means how much is remained? 1 by 3. So you will be getting log 3 value. So 2.303 by 6.93 into 10 power minus 3 whole into log 3. Log 3 value is 0.475. Log 3/4. T 3/4 is completed means how much is remained? 1/4 is remained. So it is 2.303 by 6.93 into 10 power minus 3 log 1/4. 1/4 is remained. So that you will be getting the answer. Okay students, this is what for today with respect to first order. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye bye.